the apex court of world's largest democracy, the Supreme Court of India, the highest court of India under the Constitution. Indian Constitution has established an integrated and independent judicial system. The apex court of India since 6 decades serving as custodian of Indian Constitution. Its inauguration took place on 4th of August 1958. Before this, the Supreme Court came into being on 28th January 1950. Its sitting commenced in the part of Parliament's House. From 1958, the Supreme Court of India has its permanent bench in New Delhi. The official logo of Supreme Court of India, titled the mantra Yato Dharmas Tato Jayah, which means where there is a dharma or truth, there is a victory. The Supreme Court of India succeeded the Federal Court of India after independence as highest court of appeal. Article 124 to 147 in Part 5 of Constitution deals with organization, jurisdiction, power and procedure of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court of India composed of 34 judges, which includes a CJI along with 33 judges. Originally, the strength of Supreme Court was fixed at 8. That is a Chief Justice along with 7 other judges. In 2019, the Parliament increased its strength to 34. The judges of Supreme Court are appointed by the President. The Chief Justice of India is appointed by the President with the consultation of the judges of Supreme Court through collegium system. Here, the consultation of Chief Justice of India is necessary to appoint the other judges of Supreme Court. To be a judge of Supreme Court, there are some of the qualifications prescribed under Indian Constitution, such as a person should be citizen of India, he should have been a judge of a high court for 5 years, or he should be practiced as an advocate of a high court for 10 years, or he must be a distinguished jurist in the opinion of the President. The Constitution has conferred a very extensive jurisdiction and vast powers on the Supreme Court. It is also the final interpreter and guardian of the Constitution and guarantor of the fundamental rights of the citizen. The Supreme Court of India has been remarked as most powerful court in the world. The jurisdiction and powers of the Supreme Court can be classified into original jurisdiction, in which the Supreme Court decides the disputes between different units of Indian Federation, such as between the center and one or more states, or between the center and any state, or between two or more states. In these disputes, the Supreme Court has exclusive original jurisdiction, which means no court can decide such matters, and any suit before the Supreme Court by a private citizen against the center or state cannot be entertained under this jurisdiction. The next is writ jurisdiction. The Constitution empowered the Supreme Court to issue writs for the enforcement of fundamental rights of the citizen. It is not exclusive jurisdiction, because even the high courts can empowered to issue writs for the enforcement of fundamental rights and for other purposes. But under Article 32 of Indian Constitution, the citizens are given special right to approach Supreme Court in case of violation of fundamental rights. Third, appellate jurisdiction. The Supreme Court is the highest court of appeal and hears appeals against the judgments of the lower court in constitutional matters, civil matters and criminal matters, and also appeals by special leave. But the case must involve a substantial question of law, or the case must be fit for the appeal to the Supreme Court. Fourth, advisory jurisdiction. Under Article 143 of the Constitution, authorizes the President to seek the opinion of the Supreme Court into the matters of public importance or any disputes arising between the pre-constitutional treaty or agreements. But the advices given by the Supreme Court are not binding on the President. Fifth, a court of record. The judgments, proceedings, or acts of the Supreme Court are recorded for the memory and testimony. These records are admitted to be advisory value and cannot be questioned when produced before any court. It has power to punish for the contempt of the court. The punishment can involve simple imprisonment for a term up to 6 months or fine up to 2000 rupees or both. The contempt of court may be civil or criminal. However, the innocent publications or fair comments do not amount to contempt of the court. Number 6. Power of judicial review. The power of judicial review is the power of Supreme Court to examine the constitutionality of legislative enactments and executive orders of both central and state government. On examination, if they found to be violative of the Constitution, they can declare it as null and void. Number 7. Constitutional interpretation. The Supreme Court is ultimate interpreter of the Constitution. It can give its final version applying various doctrines. And also, the Supreme Court is empowered with other powers. It decides the matters regarding the election of the President and the Vice President. It has power to review its own decision or order. It is authorized to withdraw the cases pending before the high courts and dispose them by itself. It can also transfer a case or appeal pending before one court to another high court. Its law is binding on all the courts in India. Its decree or order is enforceable throughout the country. And it has also power to control the conduct of all the courts and tribunals throughout the territory of the country. So, like this, Supreme Court is known for its power, justice, and legacy. This is all about Supreme Court of India. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment in the section below.